Hi, my name is Amalie. I'm from Singapore. I was diagnosed with young onset dementia in 2017, but was only referred to a support group 2 years later. During the initial period, it was very difficult for me and my family without support, and we had to figure out what young onset dementia is and how it would impact us as a family and me as a person living with dementia. The question is, how could that be happening in this day and age? When I was diagnosed with enteromyelitis 20 years ago, there was also little information about the disease, and yet I was not left alone and unsupported. My gynecologist went through with us the treatment option and how each choice will impact my quality of life as a woman. But when it comes to a diagnosis of dementia, you are provided with nothing except your standard prescription. So it's just like, based on the symptoms, you are likely to have young onset Alzheimer's. This is your prescription, and I will see you in 6 months' time. Are we merely symptoms of a disease to be treated? Is cognitive impairment such an undeserving condition that it is not entitled to palliative care, even though dementia is also a life-limiting medical condition like cancer? I was robbed of hope twice. One is the diagnosis itself, and second is the absence of support provided given after the diagnosis. I was poor with math to begin with, and counting from 100 by 7, which is a test of concentration and memory of the Montreal Cognitive Assessment, I'm going to give you a very accurate evaluation of my working memory issue. But if you would have asked, is there anything I am struggling on a daily basis, I would have shared my inability to manage 3 dishes plus a soup, which now has reduced to 2 dishes. I would also mention that I need to line up the ingredient in separate bowls and in the order I will cook them. I will also bring up the problem I had following the recipe, as I could not hold the information long enough in my head to use it. So please give time to history taking, because it enables healthcare professionals like you to know your patient as individuals, meet them on their terms, and see the reality of how the changes in cognitive functioning interfere with your daily life. We are individuals and not checklist items, so please avoid the tendency to pigeonhole patients with dementia. Thank you.